Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I'd like to welcome you to Lakeland's 9/11 Memorial. In case you didn't realize, and I didn't realize until a few years I was here, that the two trees represent the towers that we lost on September 11th, 15 years ago, yesterday. Before we start the ceremony here, though, we'll play the national anthem. Again, I would like to thank the Student Veterans Association for inviting me to speak a little bit today and introduce our guest speaker. And I'd like to welcome all of you to this somber remembrance ceremony. It was 15 years ago yesterday, September 11th, that our country was attacked by radical Islamists. It was a singular event in our history that was marked by the destruction of the World Trade Center in Manhattan, the attack on the Pentagon, and the loss of Flight 93 over Shanksville, Pennsylvania. For younger generations, this truly was their Pearl Harbor, and most of us assembled here today can recall exactly where we were that fateful day. Almost 3,000 people were killed and more than 6,000 injured, civilian, first responders, and military personnel. To this day, we are still losing those public safety officials to the diseases brought on by inhaling dust and debris found at the rescue site. The number of deaths related to 9/11 will grow during our lifetimes. 9/11 changed the world we live in today. We have been in persistent conflict ever since. Places like Afghanistan, Iraq, and now Syria dominate the news headlines and continue to entwine our U.S. military in brutal warfare. There have been over 6,800 military deaths and almost 51,000 wounded, and many of those have unseen wounds. In the homeland today, we face the heretofore unknown lone wolf terrorist almost daily. And the sad fact is it isn't even close to over yet. Our lives and routines have been inalterably changed forever since that fateful day. The specter of terrorism haunts our daily lives and imaginations. It fashions how we behave, where we avoid going, and our very consciousness. What do I do if something happens? Indeed, our lives are different now. So in closing, before I introduce our guest speaker, please keep those in harm's way in your thoughts and prayers. Don't forget those who continue to suffer and need help. They have done us an incredible service, and we remember them today. So now I'd like to introduce our guest speaker, Lovey Hicks. Lovey Marie Hicks is an outstanding student. I think most of us here know her. She is a proud veteran and simply an incredible woman. She is tenacious in her support for the Lakeland Students Veterans Association and many other groups at the college, including but not limited to Phi Theta Kappa and the Women's Center. As a Lakeland graduate and the recipient of the Dean's Award this past spring, she is and has always will be an inspiration and example to those around her. Lovey was also Lakeland Student Veterans Association Member of the Year for school year 15-16. No matter how long the list of awards and achievements Lovey has received, she remains humble in her own way and is willing to throw herself into any situation to help those around her. Lovey is unbelievably selfless, just like those that serve our country. I am proud to call her a comrade and fellow veteran, although Navy, and I am so glad she could be with us here today to honor those that lost their lives 15 short years ago. Please welcome Lovey.
When I was first presented with the honor of speaking today, I went on the internet and started Googling famous 9/11 speeches. I wanted to say something powerful, something profound that would stay with us throughout the day, or maybe even the year. As I tried to piece together the different quotes, it didn't sound pure. You know, it didn't sound like it was coming from me. So I sat back and thought about what happened on September 11, 2001? September 11, 2001. 15 years. 15 years since the peace of an American morning was broken, since a perfect blue sky turned into the blackest of nights. 15 years since nearly 3,000 beautiful lives were taken from us, including 125 men and women serving at the Pentagon. They were our neighbors, our friends, our husbands, wives, our brothers and sisters, and our parents. The crazy part is, we didn't just treat this like a train wreck. You know how you're just stuck and you watch it, you see it happening. No, people came out of their homes, out of their cars, out of their jobs, out of restaurants, to go and help one another. Our sorrow over the loss of so many good people should not be tempered by the example shown by so many who died and so many who lived. They taught us through their actions what it means to be human, you know? They showed us the immutable value of duty, loyalty, love, and self-sacrifice. The only way that we will triumph over terrorism and conquer the senseless tragedy of that horrible day is by celebrating the kindness of the human spirit. Today, as we remember those lost, I ask you to join me in faith that good will not only endure, but it will prevail. Americans will be meeting like this every September 11th. I'm sure to refresh our national memory of what we learned that day in 2001. We learned that we will not go quietly into the night. We will not vanish without a fight. We are going to live on in the land of the free and the home of the brave, so that others will know that love, loyalty, duty, and self-sacrifice still flourishes every day in the ordinary people living and working. Today, once more, we pray for the souls of those we remember, for you, for their families and friends who love them. In all the years that Americans have looked to these ceremonies, we have shared both words and silences. Today, I would like to share a prayer. God, our Father, giver of life, we entrust the United States of America to your loving care. You are the rock on which this nation was founded. You alone are the true source of our cherished rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. We ask that you would appoint strong, faithful men and women to serve this nation and our people. We pray for your great healing on our land. Shine your face on us, God. We need you now more than ever before. Our times are in your hands. Amen. We're going to have a moment of silence, and then Dean Becker's going to play taps. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.